If there are forests, there is life. Hello friends, how everyone is smiling, seeing me. Almost all people like me, as I am very useful for everyone. Yes, I am a tree. All my friends, small and big plants are found almost everywhere. But forests are our dwelling. We love to be there. Since ancient times, forests play vital role in humans' life. It's one of the unique gifts of nature to humans. Nowadays, when people in cities are dependent more on artificial things than natural things, there are many people who are completely depending on forests. They are called tribals. Friends, let me take you to a small village in Odisha, where people are still completely depending on forests. Learning objective: A. Realize the importance of forest. B. Explain different types of forest. C. Stating ways to conserve forests.
Ma, Jhampa and I am going to the school.
Girls, don't go through forests.
Mother, forest is our friend, and you know that every day we go through it while going to school.
All right, but go carefully.
Mani, forest is so beautiful. It is very peaceful here.
Yes, I feel today we will have an interesting day at school because our teacher will share amazing facts about forests.
Good morning, children.
Hope you all remember that today we will discuss about forests and their importance.
Yes, teacher.
We all are lucky that we live near forest. Today, you all will give me some piece of information on forests.
Yes, we all will enjoy.
We will discuss about how are forests useful for us. As you all know that planting trees for the environment is the need of the hour.
Yes, teacher. Even my father told us that the government is encouraging people to plant trees.
What do you all think? A forest can be created if thousands of trees are planted at a place?
No, teacher.
Why not?
Teacher, forests are not only important for humans, but they are equally important for animals. Forest is incomplete without them.
Absolutely correct. If I say these forests are important to maintain environmental balance, will it be right?
Yes, teacher.
If yes, why?
Teacher, didi, padap, जीव जंतु पक्षी आदि सभी जंगलों पर खाने रहने सुरक्षा आदि के लिए निर्भर हैं।
Yes, you are right. That is why we can say that forests are helpful to maintain environmental balance.
Teacher, these forests also no less than life for tribal people. They give us so many things.
All of you make a list of things we obtain from forests.
Wood, medicines, fruits, rubber, and most importantly, fresh air to breathe.
Great children, beside these, forests give us many other things.
Teacher, we want to know that what are the other things that we get from forests?
Yes, teacher.
These forests help to maintain seasonal cycle.
How do they maintain this?
Let me tell you. As you all know that in our village, it rains a lot. But do you know why?
Why, teacher?
Because there are many forests in our state.
Teacher, how these forests are able to bring rain?
Plants absorb water from the soil through their roots. This water evaporates to form clouds. As a result of which, it rains, and this is how this cycle continues.
How do forests control soil erosion?
The roots of the trees hold the particles of the fertile layer of the soil and thus prevent the erosion by wind or rain.
That's great! We didn't know that forests even bring rain and control soil erosion.
Teacher Didi, I read in the book that 1/3 of the earth is covered with forests.
You read it correct. There are variety of forests in our country.
Are there types of forests?
Yes, of course. Let us play a game. I will tell you the name of these forests and you all try to guess the type of trees found there.
It's an interesting game. Teacher, start asking questions.
Evergreen forests.
The forests which remain green.
It's correct.
How do these forests always remain green?
These forests always remain green because all the trees in the forest do not shed their leaves at the same time.
Are the trees found here are very tall?
Yes, here the trees grow very close to each other and form a canopy on the top which does not allow sunlight to reach the forest. They are found in areas where monsoon stays for longer period of time. Trees like rosewood, neem, salvadora, etc. are found here.
Children, can you tell what is wood of rosewood tree and leaves of neem tree used for?
Now you all tell me about deciduous forests.
As the name suggests, The trees might be shedding their leaves.
Absolutely correct. They are found in areas where monsoon stays for shorter period of time. Most of the teak trees are found here.
Children, do you know what is the wood of teak tree used for?
When do these trees shed their leaves?
You all have asked a very good question. Trees found here shed their leaves in summer and winter season. The new leaves grow in the months of March and April.
Teacher, can I guess the name of a forest?
Why not?
Mountain forest.
You guessed it right, Jhampa. These forests are also called coniferous forests because some trees found here bear cones instead of seeds.
Teacher, as the snow falls in the mountains, the leaves of the trees found here might not be broad.
Mani, you have drawn the right conclusion. Trees found here are all tall and have pointed leaves. The branches are bent downwards due to which, when snow falls, it slips down from the leaves.
Teacher, I'm imagining all kinds of forests.
Let me guess the name of the next forest. Teacher, are there thorn forests?
Yes, there are thorn forests. These are found in areas where there is scanty rainfall. Some trees here have thick and waxed leaves to prevent evaporation. Some trees are thorny. These thorns prevent evaporation and protect the trees from being eaten away by animals.
Nature gives us so many things. There are a variety of forests found here.
Yes, children. Nature gives us so many things. Now I will tell you about forest that you all have not thought of.
Teacher, tell quickly.
These forests are called mangrove forests. These trees are grown on the banks of rivers. These forests increase the soil brought by the rivers with them. These trees grow in swampy regions. The roots of these trees grow out of swamp and respire.
We did not know that the forests are classified on the basis of the trees. Where are these forests found?
They are found in Sundarbans in West Bengal. The forests are our treasure, which give us so many things. But they are being cut due to increase in population. We humans are cutting them to build accommodations and projects.
Knowing the fact that so many people are solely dependent on forests, they are being cut. It's a matter of concern.
Children, what do you think? Cutting off forests, displacement from forests is right? Is it harmful for animals as well as humans?
Did people ever oppose cutting of forests?
People had opposed. In 1973, the forest contractors started cutting trees in Mandal village at Alaknanda Valley in Uttar Pradesh. When the women of the village saw them cutting forest, they decided to hug the trees to save them. This was the reason why this movement was called Chipko movement. Thus, people could save forests through this movement.
Teacher, who led this movement?
Sundar Lal Bahuguna led the movement. He was an environmentalist. This movement was started to save the forest and the rights of tribal people. Like these people, if we take the responsibility to protect forest, we can save them.
Teacher, our government would have started few movements and projects to save forests.
Yes, dear. Our government has started movements like Van Mahotsav, social forestry, etc.
Teacher, we have heard that Environment Day is also celebrated.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Every year on 5th June, people all over the world celebrate this day. On this day, people plant trees and promise to save forests.
From now onwards, we all will never forget to plant trees on this day. What do you say, friends?
You are correct, Mani.
Children, as you all know that forests are the natural habitat of the animals, the environmental balance will get disturbed if there would be no forest.
We all promise to encourage people to plant trees and conserve forests.
You are right.
Very good, children.
Hope you all would have gathered information about forests and their conservation. Save it.